Rabbi Kaplan, please.
Just recently, I had a big simcha. And the simcha was not from something that I learned, but from something that's happening in the world. These days, in all the papers, they're talking about the UN resolution. All the Ummah Zolom all decided that the settlements are illegal, and maybe even being in Jerusalem is illegal, and who knows what else is illegal. I don't know what the details are of this resolution, but we know that it was Yisyatsu Malchei Eretz Rosnim Nostu Yochad Hashem Bal Mashiach. Of course, I'm not saying that we have Mashiach already, and I'm not even saying that we have an Aschalta Degul. I'm not saying any of that. But that's all between us, between Jews. We know that we're not in Aschalta Degul. We're in the end of the Golus, and we might, in a certain Bechina, we're in the darkest part of the Golus. Because Mitzad Echad, we have... We seem to be living yachasit comfortably compared to what we used to live in all the years of the Golus. On the other hand, the Yiddishkeit and the tumah of the street is so terrible. The goyishness that's influencing us is mamish the worst that it ever was. But even though we're in the end of the Golus, that's all between us, we say that. But when we talk to the Goyim on the outside, the Goyim have to respect the fact that Yidden are living in Eretz Yisrael now, and this is the place that belongs to Klai. So this is our land. It belongs to us. Hashem gave it to us. The Goyim can say, Listim Atem, the first Rashi in Chumash says, but we say, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Nosta Levisha Yosher Baina, whoever he wants to, he gives it, and he gave Eretz Yisrael to us.
Rabbi Kaplan,
Martin,
you know what I have to comment on. It's ours, but we're forbidden to take it now. We have the three O's, which we've talked about many times.
That we're talking once we're here already. We're not talking about how we got it. The three O's, that's talking about how we got Eretz Yisrael. Did we fight against the Goyim? We shouldn't fight with the Goyim. But Shaloyim Radu Ba'umos, it's called. That's something you could have talked about 80 years ago. Now, that's not relevant anymore. Yidden are here, a few million Yidden are here, and we're here. And we're here, and we have a connection to Eretz Yisrael. How we got it, if they did the right thing or not, that you could talk about 80 years ago. You missed the boat. We're now 80 years later. So, or maybe 60 or 70 years later. But it's definitely, Eretz Yisrael definitely belongs to us. Now, the Goyim, also, they don't know that Gemara about the three O's. So, when they get up in the UN, and they all say that we're in many parts of Eretz Yisrael where they're illegally, that's anti-Semitism. The Shalosh Shavuos, you can talk about in the Beis Medrash, but you can't talk about it to the Goyim. So, now, they all got up and they said there were many parts of Eretz Yisrael are illegal, and who knows what they might go further to say afterwards. And the whole government is bothering everybody, and they're all burning, and they're all saying that it's the prime minister's fault, and he caused them to say this because of the settlements that he's allowing. and they're all talking, who should we blame? This side or that side, the right, the left? And I say, just like it reminds me of the Gemara and then the Makkos, they were all bochim, but Rabbi Akiva Mitzachek, when they saw the Chorban, they saw the Makom HaMikdash with the Shul coming out, so they all cried. But Rabbi Akiva said, I see in that the Gula is close. In that Shul Yotzim Beis Kodesh HaKadoshim, Rabbi Akiva was able to see that the Gula is close. I'm saying that's in such a churban to see the Makom HaMikdash empty and a sea of foxes walking around there. To see the Gula in that, you need a Rabbi Akiva. But now,
Rabbi Kaplan.
What?
I'll just tell you a story. I once saw somebody wrote, when he came to the Kotel in 1967, he broke out in joy, tremendous joy, unlike Rabbi Akiva that you just talked about.
Yeah, right. So that's, the Chazal, they all cried when they saw the Makom HaMikdash. They weren't in joy. But Rabbi Akiva did have joy, but it's not the kind of joy that person had. Rabbi Akiva had the joy because of what a pasuk that he darshened, that in Rabbi Akiva's midrash and Eikev Ikvus of the Mashiach, that Rabbi Akiva has a connection to the end of times. Rabbi Akiva was able to see. He had such a deep look. He was able to see in the Churban, he was able to see that a Gula is going to come. But I'm saying that was in that situation of Churban. To see in that the Gula, you need a Rabbi Akiva to see it. But nowadays, we're so close to Mashiach, we don't need a Rabbi Akiva. Even small people like us can see it. And I'm saying, when you see this, what just happened in the UN, we can be mesachek. The newspapers, the shitri people, the superficial people, the amaratzim, the empty people, they're bochim on that. Baruch Hashem, Shalom Somchel Keno Kohem, Hivdilonu Minatoim. Because when us and Luna Torah, we see all that, we have to be happy. When all the Ummah Olam got up and they voted against Israel, we have no friend in the whole world. Even America voted against us. Or at least they didn't veto it. That's telling us that the Nevuah of Bilam was Miskayim. Bilam said in his Nevuah, Hein Am Levodod Yishkan. The Jewish people, they're a nation that are Levodod, they're alone. They're alone. Uvagoyim Lo Yishchashav. They're not part of all the nations of the world. Came the Zionists, when was it, 68 years ago, whenever it was, and they said, no, we're a nation like all the nations. They made a declaration of independence like all the Goyim do, and they made sure not to write the name of God in the declaration. And they kept on saying, Kochi Votzim Yodi, and they kept on making a society here that should be as goyish as can be. I want to tell you a story. My son-in-law, it hurts me to hear these kind of stories. My son-in-law, he joined a project that they send out the people to go, from people to go to Ganim, to go to kindergartens of children that are neither Chilonim or weak in Yiddishkeit, and they go once a week and they tell a story, a Sipuri Tzadikim, a story of Chazal. My son-in-law went in a certain Gan, a kindergarten, and he told the story of Nachdimon Ben Gurion, that he made sure there should be water for the Holy Regalim. So you have to explain when you tell stories. So he said, all the Jewish people came to Yerushalayim on Yom Tov, and he said, Yerushalayim, you children should know Yerushalayim is the holiest city. Do you know, he said to them, why Yerushalayim is the holiest city? The children, they said different things. And one child said, a 3-year-old or a 4-year-old, he said, yeah, because we have Kadurego here. We have soccer games. That's why it's not something to laugh at. It's something to cry about. A young, mystic, a pure, holiness Jewish child, that they prevented from him, and this is what Zionism did, they prevented from him to know even the slightest thing about what Kedusha means, what holiness means, that he sees, he hears. I mean, we look at it like Cadarego, soccer. That's just kicking out ball. It's sports. It's low life. It's people that they're interested in is developing their body. But they don't look at it that way. This little child, the Gemara says, Shusa Dinuka Beshuko Davodima. When a child talks, it's what he hears from his parents. They hear that these are heroes. These athletes are heroes, but
Rabbi Kaplan. Rabbi Kaplan.
What?
Maybe you want to say a word about Rabbi Cook and seeing the football players. Not everybody holds such an extremist view like you.
So Rabbi Cook, Rabbi Cook, he saw the good in it. He saw developing the body. It's a good thing. The body, it's a keli for the nisham. You see, Rabbi Cook, he didn't understand what's going to come out of all this. He was just looking at what was happening then, and he was he was looking for the good. So he said, well, look at this, the athletes, the Jewish athletes, they're building up their bodies. So he looked for the good. The Jewish body, building up a Jewish body. What does Hashem want? We should have a sick nation or we should have a healthy nation. So he said it's such a great thing. And they're bringing out Kedusha from it because, of course, the Jewish body is holy. But he didn't understand this. It's all Yetzer, it's all this Satan that's behind it all. He was naive. He was pushing a naive person. So he saw the good, which he was right. There is good in all this. But there's also a Yetzer and a Satan behind it all. It was definitely the Satan creating a Tarbus Yevonis, a Hellenistic society over here, a Chiloni society, a Goyishke society, in order to be like all the nations. And that's why, I mean, why couldn't they make a Medina without having a soccer team, without joining the world in having and being able to send a team to the Olympics? Why? What do we have to be part of it? No, they wanted we should be part of it. We're a nation like all the nations. Came the UN and said, you forgot that the greatest Navi of the Goyim said on you people, Einam Levodot Yishkun. You forgot that. It's not going to help you. You're never going to be a nation like all the nations. And they said it loud and clear. What does the Targum say on that pasuk? Heinam levodad yishkan, hein amad asidin lachson alaham adosi, bilchodoi asidin lachson adam. They alone are going to get Eretz Yisrael in the world to come. They alone are going to be the nation of Hashem, and all the goyim are going to be afraid of us. They're going to be alone in the next world in Mashiach's time. And now, when I hear the UN saying that you Jews are there illegally, and it's not, the point is not what they're saying about Eretz Yisrael. The point is...
Rabbi Kaplan, we're taking a break now, thank you.